make sure that cameras, video mechanisms, lights, or mobile devices of any kind that you have are turned off.
Biggest enemy is Lady Gaga. That's what I was thinking. My biggest enemy is her. Papa 911. That's a reference to the medication that I have to take when I used to panic because I'm Lady Gaga.
Well, the song was about fantasizing about women when I was in bed with my ex-boyfriend. So I didn't really want him to know because it bothered him. And that was the inspiration behind the song.
It's a true life story from beginning to end, that I was in the hospital, and then later that day, when I got home with my best friend, I got dropped from my first record label.
I want you ugly, I want your disease, all of those things that I'm saying, it's like, When you love someone so much and your fear of losing someone is so deep that you're psycho, I want you're ugly, I want all the most disgusting parts of you that you think nobody will ever love. I loved all of those things.
The song has a lot of meanings for me. I think, you know, the most obvious meaning when you first listened to it and when we were writing it was to create a song about how, you know, love is the most intoxicating, powerful drug in the world. It can just make you feel so high that you don't even realize that you're in a relationship that's not really real, that it wasn't really love at all. It was just a perfect illusion. Having trouble keeping up with other people's illusions and unable to find what's authentic in the sea of all of that. So, you know, this song is about all of those things.
In that video, I wanted to talk about the death of the celebrity. And do we kill them or do they kill themselves? So it was meant to be a pop cultural commentary. There's glamorous women dying all over the house. It was meant to be serious.
Put a sense of positivity in the world and remind people that we have love and that it's the most beautiful thing that we have and that kindness still exists, even though things, you know, don't always feel easy and can feel really hard. I think it's really great to feel grateful for what we do have, and like, love is one of those things. I think love can make all of us crazy in some types of ways, you know. It makes us do stupid things, say stupid things, but also, you know, the way that I use the word stupid in the song, it's also meant to kind of be in a little bit of a childlike way. Like, I just want your stupid love. For me, it was extremely personal. Like, how could I free myself from all the things that I felt were chaining me from being able to be free and fall in love? And what was in the way? And, you know, what's in the way for other people? So I thought about not just me when I was writing this record. I thought about the world. The lyrics, now it's time to free me from the shame. I've got to find that peace. Is it too late? Or could this love protect me from the pain? I would battle for you, even if we break in two. I freak out, look at me. All I ever wanted was love. I want you to love. It's very direct and it's very simple.
In that song, I'm saying goodbye to all my past lovers. It's symbolic of me moving on.